Welcome and good morning to all the students present in this video lecture of energy conservation and management. In this lecture, we are going to discuss more about the conclusion of energy scenario. So just we do the quick revision of previous session and then we start with the today's session. So in previous lecture, we have discussed the energy scenario. So we start with this energy primary energy mix, and then we have discussed what is the conditions or how the energy is consumed in India, and we take the reference year 2007 and we compare the data of 2007 for India as well as for the whole world. So this data is represent the primary energy mix of a whole world and which is measures in the terms of the exajoule. And exajoule, we have already know about what is exajoule. Exajoule is the 10 to the power 18. Now, after that, we have discussed the Indian primary energy mix, and we know that it is a 24 exajoule. And then we compare, and what is the energy uses are there in our day-to-day life that we have discussed. Then we have discussed the installed capacity of in India. Then we have discussed the coal supply, oil supply, natural gas supply, and we have stopped up to this point or these slides. So now today we'll start with these slides. So let's start the conclusion from my point of view. See here, after the studying of this all the supplies, this slides is there, which shows the Indian fossil fuel reserves. So this is the reserve as on the 2006 data, that oil is reserve is very less, that is a 760 million tons. This is 34,000 million tons of lignite is there. There is natural gas and the uranium. So students, see here, we have the less oil. So we need to depend on the other country, other nations, and that's why we have to spend. And why oil is major source of energy that is required? Because 80%, more than 80% of this oil is used in the transport sectors. And if you know the coal power plants and the mine in the India, there is a huge or the large distance is there, large distance between the mine and the power plants. And that's why we need to transport this coal from mine to the power plant. And that's why the major and other also good transportations is required. So total oil consumption, out of that, near about 80% of oil that is used in the transport sectors. And if we have changed these transport sectors from the oil consumption to the we know that currently we are using the CNG gas. All of you heard about that CNG gas is there for the transportation sectors. Now we have this EV we are recently invented. So this is the things that why we have to go for this alternative in the transport sectors. As well as in India, there is a huge potential or huge reserves are there in the column of the radioactive fuels, means the uranium and like that. Actually, in India, we have major nuclear fuel, that is a thorium. We have large amount of, second in the world, we have the largest amount of the thorium reserves are there in our country. So we need to switch our consumption or the power productions from our traditional, that is a thermal, to the nuclear power stations. So if we are able to establish the nuclear power station in India, then it can be solve our problems. As well as now, what is other things are there? If you're going, the larger amount of coal is burning, the major amount of pollutants are emitted by burning of this coal. So among that, SO2 emission is there because the sulfur is contained in the coal and oil. Then the nitric oxide is also there, then CO, then SPM, that is creates a visibility issues. It is called as suspended particular matters in the environment. Then we have the CO2,
which is very harmful, and the CFC gases. CFC gases is very dangerous because it is depleted the ozone layer, and due to which the ultraviolet energies or ultraviolet rays of the suns are reaching towards the earth, and that is reason for the greenhouse effect as well as the global warming. So we need to use the alternative solutions which pollutes or which generates the less amount of pollutants. And if we are switching from the oil, gas and the coal, from their three resources, fossil fuel, to if we switch towards the nuclear power generating capacities or the nuclear power stations, then this all these kind of energies are reduces, means this all kind of pollutants generation is very, very less with the use of the nuclear power energies. Then second things, this is some conclusive remarks are there. Need for alternatives. The fossil fuels reserves are limited, as we have seen the data in the previous slide, that our fossil fuel is limited, and India contributes near about 18 or 17% of world population, where it is only contribute a 4% of primary energy source. So we need to increase the consumptions of energy, and that is possible by over 52% of household is unelectrified. Nowadays this number is increases, but we need to focus to provide the electricity in the remote area where the electricity is not presently available. And if we are providing the electric energy, then our consumption is increases. And the second thing is present pattern. It is very important. Predominantly fossil fuel based means the total pattern of consumption for the India is predominantly dependent on the fossil fuels, and which emits the larger amount of the pollutions. So we need to go from the fossil fuel to the renewable energy, as well as we need to go for the nuclear power. Linkage between energy services and the quality of life. As you can see, we are living in Gujarat, and we are fortunate enough to have the 24 hours availability of electric energy. If you are going in some of the state of in India, I'm not taking the particular name of that state, then there is a large amount of lacking, or only few hours of energy is available. If you are going in the other states, then in day there is 8 hours of the electricity cut is there. Power cut is for more than 6 or 8 hours in a day is there. And so in some of the state, only 6 to 8 hours electricity is available, because we are living in the Gujarat and we have large amount of power productions, and that's why we have 24/7 the electricity is available in our home. And that's why we are not very correlate this last sentence, that is a linkage between the energy services and the quality of life. So this is the my conclusive points from the energy scenario. First, now I'm going to conclude that India currently use predominantly fossil fuel based primary source of energy, and which generate the larger amount of pollutions. And India is having a 17% of world population where it consumes only 4 to 5% of primary energy. So we need to consume the more energy for switching to developing country to the developed country. And this is happens by providing the more amount of electricity to the various households of an India, in the remote places of an India. In the various states, there is a huge numbers of unelectrified field is there. So we need to provide the electricity to that fields. And with the help of this kind of things, we are going to increase our primary energy consumptions. And we also need to change our primary consumption pattern from the fossil fuel to the renewable one. And this is a conclusive remarks from the energy scenario. And now, we have one solutions. Primary energy consumption of India, of whole world. Then we have discussed the energy end uses, where we are using the energy. Then installed capacity of the power. Then we have discussed the coal supply, oil supply, natural gas supply. Then we come with the current reserves of Indian fossil fuels. And then from this point, we have come with some conclusion that by the consumptions of the fossil fuels, we are polluting a more amount of the different pollutant, which badly affect our the quality of air. And now we have go for the conclusive remarks that fossil fuels reserves are limited. Second is the India is having a 17% of world population, but it is only consumed the 4% of primary energy. The present pattern is predominantly fossil fuel based, so we need to change this pattern. And in India, 52% of household is an unelectrified. Then linkage between the energy services and the quality of life means if we want to change the living standards or the living qualities of a person or an humanities on our country, then we must need to supply the more amount of energy services. And if we are providing the electricity to our all the unelectrified areas, then definitely our primary consumption is increases. But now whenever we are going to supply the major amount of energy, then we depends on the fossil fuels. It means if you generate more amount of power in our current power station, it consumes the more amount of fossil fuels, which is burning the more amount of fuels like oil and coal, and which generates the major amount of pollution. So for preventing of these pollutions, as well as we need to satisfy of supply of electricity to our unelectrified fields, then we need to depend on the renewable energy sources, as well as we need to change the our consumption pattern for the primary energy from coal, oil to the uranium and other resources, because we have the larger amount of the nuclear power plant, as well as we have greater potentials to have cultivated the various kind of renewable energy like the solar energy, wind energy, geothermal, tidal energy, because we have geographical advantages to cultivate this major kind of renewable energy sources. So this is the conclusion of the Indian energy scenario. Now we can be able to give the solution strategies for the our drawbacks of the Indian conservations, Indian energy scenario. So first steps to have this energy conservation means to conserve the energy is very simple, and the first step of this energy pyramid. In second steps, we have to go for the energy efficiency. See, conservation means to conserve where it is not utilized, or reduce the use wastage of the various energy. Later on in the next slides, we are going to have discussions on energy conservation. Then second is energy efficiency. And third level of energy pyramid is to use the renewable energy sources. So this is a very good amount of the levels for achieving our objectives that we have derived from the learning of Indian energy scenario. That first we have to go for the energy conservation, then we have to go for the energy efficiency, and lastly we have to depend on the renewable energy sources. Because in energy conservation, we do not require any kind of investment. We do not have to change anything. In energy efficiency, we have to do the little modifications. And in the renewable energy, we require the larger amount of initial investments. So that's why the steps of the pyramid is there. It is in line with this all the criteria. So now we discuss first the energy conservations and energy efficiency. If you have heard the energy conservation and energy efficiency, both are near to have a same meaning, but it is the separate from each other and have the related concept. It is not a same word, but it has a separately have some meanings and concepts, and that's why we have to go to discuss this both the words in brief. The energy conservation is achieved when the growth of energy consumption is reduced, measured in physical terms. Conservation, it means you do not have to put any kind of efforts, but you need to reduce the requirement. You need to observe the waste and you have to reduce this waste without any kind of change in the system that is established. The energy conservation can thereof, but the results of several processes or the development such as productivity increases or the technological processes. See here, in this world, the productivity is definitely increases whenever you have achieved the energy conservation. Or in other words, you can say that if your productivity is increases, definitely you have conserved the energy. And energy efficiency is achieved when the energy intensity in a specific product, process, or area of productions or the consumption is reduced without affecting the output, consumption, or the comfort level. This is very important. You do not have to go to affect the output of the process, the consumption of an industries, or the comfort level of a human, and you have to reduce the energy requirement. Then it is called as the energy efficiency. So I think it is clear in your mind that what is the energy conservations and energy efficiency. Now we are going over here. We have different types of renewable energy like the solar energy, wind energy, bioenergy. Bio means biogas, biomass, biodiesel. That's all the energy which is used from the bioagriculture waste. Then geothermal is there and the tidal energy is there. Then energy conservation objectives. This is the last today we are going to discuss, and then after discussions of this slide I end the session. So broadly, the energy conservation program initiated at micro and macro levels will have the following objectives of manufacturing goods: either lower processes or increase the efficiency, availability and probabilities, and in consecutions raise the standards of living both for workers and the industry and of those who buy the products. It means not only it is benefited to the industry, it is also benefited to the consumers or the which buy the products. So now let us discuss from first to reduce the import of energy and reduce the drain of foreign exchange. It is very easy and understandable, so I'm not discussing more on that. Second is to improve the export of manufacturing goods or energy or both. So with the help of these second strategies, we can able to improve our GDP, and which is leads towards the more energy consumptions, and which is leads towards the development of a country. C, to reduce the environment pollutions per unit of industrial output as carbon dioxide, smoke, sulfur, so which can reduce the global warming effect and living standard of D, reducing the cost that pollutants increase either directly or as damage or as needing the special measures to combat it once the pollutant are produced. And last is generally to relieve the shortage and improve the development. So these are the conservation objectives, and with these objectives we are going to conserve the energy and we have to go for the energy efficiency. So here one example is given. We are going to discuss this energy benefits, energy efficiency benefits, as well as this example in the next lectures. And then after that, we are going to discuss the principle of energy conservations. So thank you for attending this lecture. Thank you.